Hey everyone, I'm Sarcastic Gettles, and this time I'm going to be doing something just a little bit differently. So, as you know from part four of this, Alicemare part five was unfortunately just a bad situation. It didn't record the webcam very well, I didn't get the game audio very well, and then at the same time, I discovered that I didn't even have the commentary microphone track. I was originally just gonna kind of post a collage of events that happened at the beginning of part six, but then I thought I would sit down and kind of just talk about what happened, since that's kind of what you do during a Let's Play anyway. It's just a much more condensed format. So basically, episode five, I thought was really interesting. So you have these gross, like, Kirby-looking enemies in all of these different rooms, and it took me like 4 or 5 minutes to discover that if you go to the end of the rooms, there are these holes in the wall, and these holes in the wall have different eyes in them with different colors looking in different directions, and then you have to go to the centerpiece where that curtain is and figure, you know, it'll ask you which way is the red eye looking, which way is the yellow eye looking, which way is the blue eye looking. And it took me a minute to catch on to that, if I'm being honest, just because I was afraid that these little things were gonna move and I was gonna die. But that didn't end up being the case. They didn't move the entire time. And I got the puzzle, and then you go into this like really creepy, just dark nothingness with all of these things around, and you walk up and you get the world key. And then you get another piece of the story. And the story basically read as follows. It was Father went cold, he really did. I told Mother, but she didn't believe me. Quite some time passed before my brother and sister noticed, and she finally realized. She made a face I'd never seen before, a face I didn't want to see. There wasn't a surprise or anger or smiling or laughter. After that day, Mother stopped saying anything. She was just silent. Coldly staring somewhere. So that story plays out, and then you get to the top, and there's a door going into the next room, and Josh really doesn't want to go in. And quite personally, I don't blame him. So whenever you finally get in the room, the cat comes in and he starts taunting you, and he basically tells Josh, like, what you're looking at, whatever you see here, you know, it's your fault. And Josh realizes he thinks it's a doll at first. And then he says, no, that's my mom. And his mom is just hanging from the ceiling, which is completely happy and normal, of course. So his mom is hanging from the ceiling, and the cat is taunting him. A bunch of eyes just pop up everywhere, which is great. And Josh kind of freaks out a little. Him and the cat go back and forth, talking about how it's all, you know, Josh's fault. And the cat then takes off, and you get another little snippet of story with another notebook scrap that read, "My big brother's good at soccer. My big sister is smart, but I'm nothing. I'm nothing, but I said I'm something. I have nothing, but I say I do. And I got so sad after I said it. Soon enough, I didn't know what I had or what I was. No matter what I say, it might just hurt someone." After that, you know, you always get that little last snippet where it's like, oh, well, I wonder what this says, because everything's all crossed out. And it's like, but I still, I'm imagining still, but I still say something, but I still say it. Teacher, what am I supposed to do? I think that's, I'm pretty sure that's what that one was supposed to say. But I still say it. Teacher, what am I supposed to do? I still want to know how teacher's connected to all this. It's been driving me up a wall. Even after recording episode up to eight now, I think, I still don't quite know what teacher's doing, or who he is. Maybe not who he is, but like what his purpose is exactly. But anyway, I think essentially what happened with Josh's story is, again, these are all fairy tale based. So in this case, he is the boy who cried wolf. You know, he said a bunch of different things that weren't necessarily true, because it would make his mom laugh and make her smile because she thought it was cute and funny. And then slowly she was like, it's not cute and funny anymore. Now you're just lying all the time. Then it turns out the dad dies, and he tries to tell her that, And she doesn't believe him, and she doesn't really believe him until the other kids, his siblings, notice, and then she takes notice. And now that she knows the dad is dead, and he wasn't lying this one time, she, like, freaks out and goes into a depression state and then kills herself. Which is just lovely. But yeah, so that's generally what happened in part five. And again, I'm really sorry that I wasn't really able to get that episode out, traditionally speaking, I guess, with webcam and my general first reaction. But anyway, there you go. That is Alicemare part five. I hope you even remotely enjoyed this little, I wouldn't call it behind the scenes, but this kind of like look back at me just trying to explain what happened, because I really didn't want any of this footage to go completely unused. So moving on to part six next. That one I know for sure everything's good, and hopefully there won't be any issues in the future. So thank you all for understanding. Thank you all for watching. Make sure you hit the notification bell if you want to catch the next part, and I will see you all then. Like, actually see you. You'll see my face instead of just my voice over some footage. Anyway, thank you all. See you next time. Bye-bye.